What's going on? It's Keke, aka Shyfacediva. Thank you for joining me in the kitchen again. Today we're going to be doing penne pasta casserole. And as I show you guys along the way, I'm going to tell you different alternatives you can do. Right now I'm just putting some extra virgin olive oil in the pan. I'm going to be sauteing some onion and bell pepper. Okay, so I'm just going to add the onion and bell pepper. And this is one medium onion and one large bell pepper. Okay, so I'm just going to let this saute down so it can get nice and tender. While everything is simmering down, I like to add a little kick to my bell pepper and onion. I'm just going to put some black pepper. And add some garlic powder. Okay, I'm just gonna mix this up. Okay, so I think we're done here. I started to see some caramelizing on the onion and the bell pepper. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut my eye off. Okay, what we got here is a pound of ground turkey and a pound of ground beef. Whichever one you choose is fine. I'm going to be using both. You can also replace it with some sausage, or you can actually just have the cheese and pasta sauce and pasta if you don't want the meat added to it. I already cooked and drained it. Oh yeah, another thing, while you're prepping everything, go ahead and set your oven to 350. The next thing I'm going to do is add 2 packs of Italian mushroom and spaghetti sauce mix. I'm just going to be using this for added flavor. Add the 2nd pack. Okay, so I'm going to mix that in really good. Okay, after I mixed up the seasoning really good, I'm going to go ahead and add those onions and bell pepper that we sauteed. The next thing I'm going to do is add a jar of pasta sauce, and this is just a ragu mushroom sauteed onion and mushroom, and this is the 1 pound jar. Just want to pour it in our cooked meat and just mix it up. After I mix the 1 jar of pasta sauce, I'm looking at the texture of it. And if I was just doing regular spaghetti, this would be enough. But since I'm going to be putting this in the oven, I want to add a little bit more sauce to it, because once that casserole cooks, you don't want the pasta sauce to dry out while it's baking. So we're going to add a little bit more of pasta sauce to give it a little bit more flow in it, okay? I'm going to take another jar of ragu sauce, and I'm going to add 1/2 of that to see what I'm working with. So this time I'm only going to add 1/2 a jar. Okay, so let's stir it up to see where we're at. Okay, we're almost there. I think I'm going to go ahead and just add the rest of it. Okay, so that's 2 jars of sauce total. We want to make sure that pasta be nice and cheesy and moist and not dry. So let's stir this up. Okay, this is the perfect consistency. So for 2 pounds of meat, I added 2 jars of pasta sauce, and that is 1 pound per jar. The next thing I'm going to do is add 1/2 cup of Parmesan cheese, and this is the kind that I use. And I'm just going to mix that up really good. Okay, so I already cooked my penne pasta, and I already buttered it and drained. And this is the pasta right here, penne pasta. But if you don't have this type of pasta on hand, you can use elbows or whatever pasta that you have on hand. This is optional. The next thing I'm going to do is add a half a cup of the Parmesan cheese to the pasta and stir it up really good. The next thing you want to do is combine the meat mixture to the pasta. Okay, after I'm done mixing up, I'm checking it out, and I like the consistency, but just for a little extra to make sure it won't dry out, I'm just going to add a small can of plain tomato sauce. It's just an 8-ounce can, okay? Okay, so that should be really good. This way, your casserole won't dry out. The next thing you want to do is transfer your mixture to a baking dish. This is a 9x13, 13x9 baking dish, and I just sprayed it with some non-stick spray. Okay, after I put half of the mixture in a baking dish, I went ahead and put sliced cheese in the middle, and then I'm going to put the remaining on top. You can also replace this with shredded cheese, any type that you like. Okay, after I put the remaining of the mixture in the baking dish, I'm just going to top it off with shredded cheese and Parmesan cheese. The last thing I'm going to do is just dust it with some cilantro, just for presentation. Okay, we're going to place this in the oven on 350, and there's not a specific time when it's finished, just when it heat through and all the cheese melt on top. So I'll be back with the finished product. Okay guys, this is the finished product. I let it stay in there for 30 minutes. As you can see, the outside has a nice crust on it, and I'm pretty sure the inside is moist. Okay, so let's go ahead and plate it. Okay, after I put some in the plate, I just want to show you guys the inside. As you can see, it's nice and moist. You can see the sauce. It's not dry at all. So I'm really glad I put the two jars plus the small can of tomato sauce. Okay guys, this is the finished product. As you can see, the Parmesan on top. You can see that cheese that I put in the middle. And I paired it with corn on the cob and butter garlic toast. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.